doing some pasture clearing and getting rid of all this brush. I've got to turn the camera on, so I've got a little bit of work done. Right straight ahead there where that big oak tree is, where we've been working in the hay field, and I've been coming in here. I've got two big brush piles behind me already. Just worked my way down. This is where one of the log landings was. So there's a lot of mess here that I'm cleaning up. And I just got excited when I got down here and didn't start videoing. Basically, I'm just taking and moving some of this junk so we can get down to a decent landing pad here. Start moving all these tops and brush in the brush piles. I read an old article the other day, way back when, that showed how the old timers cleared property, and I've used it a little bit thus far, you know, besides I'm using modern day equipment, and it has worked out phenomenally well for burning stumps and getting rid of the brush and how they went about clearing land with minimal tools and more or less manpower and some horse and mule power. Got plenty of horsepower with this equipment. We're going to take advantage of that, but their burning methods, how they went about everything, we're going to follow it for a little bit and see how it pans out for us. So these log piles got so big with sticks in it, we're going to break some of them down. load, they're making that train car load directly from the manufacturer, where it could drop off, directly from the manufacturer of the dynamite. And it talked about getting several of the neighbors together to be able to afford to order a rail car full of dynamite. And it, the cost savings was phenomenal. So if it's, it's stated that there was 40 cents a pound for dynamite, they said if you bought it by the car load directly from the manufacturer, it would only cost you around, I want to say it was a penny per stick. Like 5 or 6 cents a pound. I'd have to read back on the article, but it was a phenomenal cost savings. And back then, they talked about getting all your neighbors together. Y'all helped each other clear, and that's how you could do it. You know, economically, get several neighbors together and clear your acreage, and then in turn, you'd go help them clear their acreage. Back when people was a lot better than they are now, everybody wanted to help everybody. Nowadays, everyone's out for themselves. It's part of it. I wish we could go back to the old times. It's a rare thing these days. Find somebody with some gusto. Now, if I can get this cleared up, I'm working down side of the log road, right in front of me right there, that big oak tree right by the bucket, that was the original road they tried to push in here to bring all the timber out from the back of the property. We originally cut about 35 acres here, and that logger left quite a mess, and that's what we're cleaning up now. But the back acreage that was timber, that logger did a phenomenal job. Of course, he had equipment, and both of these loggers came through the forester. But if I'd have knew about the back logger, he would have got this front section tampered, because he did a phenomenal job. There's nowhere near the brush piles. He pretty much pulled everything to the
further down on the far side of what's now going to be our main
them if I can cross them, I will. But that was too deep to cross. And I know I can walk myself across it, but with all this brush and regrowth and weeds and grass, it's hard to see what you're doing, even holding myself up with a bucket and a blade. The last thing I want to do is sink this one.
Squeeze that fork.
just brush and log and grass and get it piled up, because then it will start the drying process. Sometime this fall, we'll burn all this stuff. This is not as important. We've already burned off all those brush piles in the hay field. We'll have another video on just the hay field. We basically took land just like this. Stumped, and it's been completely de-stumped and all the residue piled and burned. And I've got what's left of the brush piles to do away with. And what I'll do is, there's very few stumps left. Using that old timer's method, the stumps burn very, very well. It takes a little bit extra work. Next thing on stumps is make sure you have all of the dirt you can out of them, and while they're burning, keep the pile packed as tight as you possibly can. Now you can look right here, this is all topsoil. There's a little bit of residue on that, but that's because I'm sitting on top, but there's some very good, I'm sitting on look how empty truck loads of topsoil, and that'll all be spread back out across that road. Away from all the streams and everything.